Good evening, everybody. I'm Stan Stovall.
I'm Donna Hamilton. Thank you for joining us. Our big story at 5, well, they nabbed the first one, and now the latest murder suspect labeled public enemy number one is off the street.
And tonight, police are hoping it signals that Baltimore has now turned a corner and getting citizens involved in stopping the violence. 11 News I-Team lead investigative reporter Jane Miller is live outside police headquarters tonight with more. Jane?
Stan, Capone Chase lasted less than 4 days on the street after police put out his picture and made a very big public deal about the allegations against him. They credit something they haven't been getting a lot of in recent years. 19-year-old Capone Chase was arrested early this morning in the 1500 block of Pennsylvania Avenue in West Baltimore. He's accused in the fatal shooting on a Southeast Baltimore playground earlier this month of 21-year-old Ramon Rodriguez.
Mr. Capone lured Mr. Rodriguez to this location, which happened to be a playground, and he murdered him in cold blood.
According to charging documents, Chase and another unknown man forced Rodriguez to kneel on the playground and empty his pockets. Then Chase allegedly shot and killed him. Police put Chase's picture out Monday. His capture, they say, came quickly because the public stepped up with information. The public's cooperation has been in short supply in the past. Police hope they figured out how to gain an extra set of eyes and ears with public enemy designations.
We hope to get a lot more because when we put out that it's a public enemy, number one, and that he's committed this heinous crime in a playground where children and families are, the public wants to get involved.
Chase's arrest follows the arrest last week of murder suspect Daryl Anderson, accused in 2 murders, one each in the city and Baltimore County. Anderson was the first suspect to earn public enemy designation. The alleged crimes of the men have no connection, but they do share something each police say is affiliated with the Black Gorilla Family gang, and each bears a distinctive cross-like tattoo on his forehead. Daryl Anderson is still in Alabama, where he was caught last week. Baltimore County State's Attorney Scott Schellenberger says he has waived extradition and arrangements are now underway to bring him back to Maryland. Reporting live tonight from Baltimore Police Headquarters, I'm Jane Miller, WBAL-TV 11 News.
All right, Jane, thank you. Meanwhile